Dear students, now we will see how to construct the displacement diagram and the construction of cam profile under cycloidal motion. Now, example 4. A cam is to give the following motion to a knife-edged follower outstroke during 160 degree of cam rotation, dwell for the next 30 degree of cam rotation, return stroke during next 100 degree of cam rotation, and dwell for the remaining 70 degree of cam rotation. The stroke of the follower is 40 millimeter and the minimum radius of the cam is 50 millimeter, rotating in counterclockwise. The follower moves with cycloidal motion during both the outstroke and return strokes. Draw the profile of the cam when the axis of the follower passes through the axis of the camshaft. Determine the maximum velocity and maximum acceleration of the follower when the camshaft rotates at 500 rpm. Now, using this data, in order to construct the displacement diagram, particularly to mark the dimensions along x-axis represents angle of rotation of the cam. These values are in degree. In order to mark these values along x-axis, we should select some suitable scale. Here, along x-axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 20 degree. Along y-axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. According to this considered scale, the outstroke angle become 8 cm, like 160 degree divided by 20 degree become 8 cm, that is equals to 80 millimeter. Similarly, dwell angle become 1.5 cm, that is equals to 15 millimeter. Return stroke angle become 5 cm, that is equals to 50 millimeter. Remaining dwell period become 3.5 cm, that is equals to 35 millimeter. Now we will see how to find the angular velocity of cam, maximum velocity and maximum acceleration during outstroke and return strokes. Omega 2 pi n by 60. Here the value of n, nothing but camshaft rotates at 500 rpm. So this is n value. Substitute in this equation after simplifying, that is equals to 52.359 radians per second. Then next, maximum velocity during outstroke, that is equals to 2 into omega into s divided by theta suffix naught. Here omega, angular velocity, s nothing but stroke of the follower, and theta suffix naught, outstroke angle. Here substitute omega in radians per second, s value in meter, outstroke angle in terms of radians. This 160 degree in terms of radians become 2.79. After simplifying this equation, that is equals to 1.50 meter per second. Next, maximum velocity during return stroke, that is equals to 2 into omega into s divided by theta suffix r. Here omega value, s value in meter, and return stroke angle, that is 100 in terms of radians, that is 1.74. After simplifying this equation, that is equals to 2.40 meter per second. Next, maximum acceleration during outstroke, that is equals to 2 pi omega square into s divided by theta suffix naught square. So here also omega in radians per second, s in meter, outstroke angle in radians. Here we can see those values. After simplifying this equation, that is equals to 88.51 meter per second square. Then maximum acceleration during return stroke, that is equals to 2 pi omega square s divided by theta suffix r square. Here all these values with suitable unit we can see here. Then after simplifying this equation, that is equals to 227.57 meter per second square. Like this we can determine angular velocity, maximum velocity during outstroke and return stroke, maximum acceleration during outstroke and return stroke. Now we will see how to construct the displacement diagram under cycloidal motion with step by step. Under step one, at any convenient position, draw a line along x-axis. Here, as we know that, we can construct this displacement diagram either using plane sheets or even in graph sheets also. Now, with suitable position, draw a line along x-axis, represents angle of rotation of the cam. Along y-axis, stroke, nothing but displacement of the follower. Under step one, mark the dimensions along x-axis. According to the considered scale, outstroke angle become 80 millimeter, first dwell become 15 millimeter, return stroke become 50 millimeter, next dwell period become 35 millimeter. The summation of this gives us one rotation of the cam, nothing but 360 degree rotation of the cam. After this, under step two, mark the dimension along y-axis equal to the displacement of the follower according to the considered scale, that is 40 millimeter. First mark 40 millimeter along y-axis, project horizontally up to some certain position. Then project the end of cam rotation somewhere it will intersect. Like this, close this box. Under step three, according to displacement diagram procedure, we should select one of the even number. Correspond to that, we need to divide the outstroke distance and return stroke distance. Now, we need to divide this outstroke and return stroke distance with any even number of equal part. Here, I will select that even number as 6. If we divide this 80 mm into 6 equal part, 80 divided by 6 equal to that value from the beginning of outstroke, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here we can see the color coding for the divisions. Similarly, during return stroke, divide this 50 into 6 equal part, then name the divisions from left to right, 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and 0 dash. Under step 4, after dividing the outstroke and return stroke into the selected even number, like 6 equal parts of this outstroke and return stroke distance, through all these divisions, next we need to draw the vertical lines up to the 40 mm locus. From 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, during outstroke, draw the vertical lines up to 40 mm locus. Similarly, during return stroke, through all these divided points, draw the verticals up to the 40 mm locus. Step 5. This is very important under cycloidal motion. Next step, in order to find the proper path of the displacement of follower, here we need to generate a circle. In order to generate a circle, first we need to find a radius of that circle. The mathematical equation to find the radius of the generating circle is the ratio of stroke divided by 2 pi. Here we can see small r, radius of the generating circle. It is the ratio of stroke divided by 2 pi. Stroke nothing but, that is 40, take in terms of millimeter, divided by 2 pi. After simplifying this equation, we can get 6.36 millimeter. So 6.36 millimeter represents radius of the generating circle. Here, 12.74, it becomes diameter. So diameter of this generating circle is 12.74. Use proper tools, draw a circle of radius 12.74. Now here I am explaining step by step to construct this generating circle. Later I will tell you how to take this circle as a center of what? Actually, we need to construct this circle as a center of 0 at the beginning of outstroke or at the end of return stroke, like 0 dash as center. First, I will explain how to generate this circle with step by step. Okay, then we need to place here. According to your construction method, we can take directly at the beginning of outstroke, like 0 as center or 0 dash as center. The choice is yours. When both outstroke and return stroke takes place with cycloidal motion. Now, first generate a circle having diameter 12.74. Next, divide this circle into that same selected even number, like 6. Here, if you take circle, nothing but 360 degree, divide this 360 degree into 6 equal part, 360 divided by 6 for every 60 degree from the origin reference in clockwise, first 60 degree, next 60, next 60, next 60 degree, next 60 degree, and next 60 degree. Next, with sequence in clockwise sense, name the divisions 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Interestingly, the 0.6 coincide at 0. Next step, join the point 1 and 2. Join the point 1 and 2 with thin straight line. Join point 4 and 5 with thin straight line. Now, through the CG of this circle, draw the vertical up to the intersecting of point path 1, 2, intersecting path of point 4 and 5. Now here we can see the red dots. There are three red dots. One is CG of this circle. Another one, where it exactly this vertical line intersects the path of the point joining 4 and 5. And this vertical path joining the path of the joining point of 1 and 2. Like this, we need to find these three points. This is very important. So like this, we need to construct this circle as a center of 0 dash or as a center of 0 dash as center. Now, here, if we consider the point 0 as center, construct this circle according to this procedure. After finishing this circle as a center of 0 at the beginning of outstroke, in the next step, step number 6, through the CG of this circle, the meaning of this CG, nothing but it joins the point 3, 0 and 6. Through this point, draw a line with thin straight line up to the end of outstroke. It become diagonal line must passing through this CG of this circle. Parallel to this line, draw one more line parallel to this through this point, nothing but the point joining the vertical and path of 4, 5. Similarly, through this point, parallel to this diagonal, through this point, draw a line with thin straight line. So why I have stopped at here? Because the meaning of this point joins the point 1 and 2. And if we draw the line parallel to this diagonal, okay, this path must intersect first and second vertical line. Same way, this diagonal path also must intersect 0, third vertical line and sixth vertical line. Similarly, this path must intersect the fourth vertical and fifth vertical. With reference to this, we can determine the intersecting points. But method to find intersecting points under cycloidal motion, this is the procedure. Now, under step 7, let me find the intersecting points. First, CG of the circle intersect 0 vertical line at here. This is the diagonal line also intersect the 0 vertical line at here. That is one of the intersecting point. Next, this is the first vertical and this first vertical intersecting by this path. Okay, that is 1, 2 point. This is the line parallel to this. Intersect the first vertical line at here. Then the second vertical line, the same path intersect at here. And this is the third vertical line intersecting by this respective path here. Next, the fourth vertical line intersecting, now it is by this line because this is the point joining of points 4 and 5. This is the path parallel to this diagonal, and this path intersects the fourth vertical line at here and fifth vertical line at here. Similarly, this, the diagonal line intersects one more vertical line, that is sixth vertical line at the end of outstroke. After finding these intersecting points, through all these points, draw the line horizontally up to the respective vertical lines intersect during return stroke. Means zero line comes along x-axis, then this first vertical line intersect at here, draw the horizontal line up to one dash vertical line. Next, two second vertical line intersect at here, project this point up to two dash vertical point. This is the third vertical line intersect at here, project this up to three dash vertical line. This is the fourth vertical line intersect at here, project this point up to four dash vertical line intersect at here. Fifth vertical line intersect at here, project this point up to the fifth dash vertical line intersect at here. Then the sixth vertical line intersect at here, project up to the sixth dash vertical line intersection here. So like this, we can determine the intersecting points during outstroke and return stroke under cycloidal motion. Then let me name these intersecting points from the beginning: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, and P. P is coincide at zero dash, similar to A coincide at zero. So this is the method to find the intersecting points during outstroke and return stroke under cycloidal motion. Now under step 9, we need to join all these intersecting points with thick parabolic arc during outstroke and return stroke from the first intersecting point, A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to F, F to G. But during first dwell, it comes along the 40 mm locus. It is a straight line, represents the follower stable at TDC. Next, from the beginning of return stroke, that is from H, with parabolic arc, join the intersecting points H to J, J to K, K to L, L to M, M to N, N to P with thick parabolic arc. Then remaining dwell period, P to Q, during this period, the follower stable at BDC, join with thick straight line. Finally, this red line indicates this is the path of the follower displacement during outstroke, first dwell, return stroke, and during second dwell period. Under step 9, let me see how to construct the velocity diagram and acceleration diagram with reference to this displacement diagram. This is the displacement diagram constructed with respect to cycloidal motion condition. Now, in order to construct this velocity diagram and acceleration diagram, first we should take some reference lines with thin straight dashed lines. So project vertically downward from here, from the beginning of outstroke up to some certain position, from here, we can see from the beginning of outstroke here, this is the mid position of outstroke, and this is the end of outstroke. And also here, very carefully, exactly at 20 millimeter, exactly at 40 millimeter, exactly at 60 millimeter, then exactly at the end of outstroke. Here, the meaning, beginning 20 millimeter, nothing but this is 1/4 of the outstroke distance. Look at here, this is the outstroke distance. 1/4 of outstroke distance become 20, 1/2 of outstroke distance become 40, 3/4 of outstroke distance become 60, and the end of outstroke. Similarly, during return stroke, beginning, mid position, end, and also 1 by 4th of return stroke distance, 1 by 2, this is 3 by 4th of return stroke distance, then end of return stroke. Like this, during outstroke and during return stroke, four vertical lines we need to take as a reference up to some certain position. Now, at any convenient position, draw a line horizontally. This line becomes the reference to construct this velocity diagram. Already we know that how to find the maximum velocity during outstroke and return stroke using these formulas. Already we have determined those values with suitable scale. Mark first maximum velocity during outstroke, that is exactly at 1 by 2 of outstroke distance. 1 by 2 of outstroke distance exactly at mid position become maximum. Mark this point during return stroke exactly at 1 by 2 of return stroke distance exactly at 25 millimeter towards downward with reference to this horizontal line. Mark the maximum point. Then take the path from the beginning of outstroke, join to maximum, then to end of the outstroke with parabolic arc with thick line. During dwell period, that motion become constant, comes along the reference line from the beginning of return stroke towards downward and up to maximum, then up to the end of return stroke joined with parabolic arc. During return second dwell period, so again the velocity become constant, it comes along the reference line, so up to the end of cam rotation. This is the method and the shape to construct the velocity diagram under cycloidal motion. Next, acceleration diagram. Here, using these equations, we know how to determine maximum acceleration during outstroke and return stroke. During outstroke, the acceleration become maximum exactly at 1 by 4th of outstroke. 1 by 4th of outstroke, again at 3 by 4th of outstroke. 1 by 4th at 20 millimeter, 3 by 4th of outstroke distance at 60 millimeter become maximum. Mark this maximum positions. Now join beginning, maximum, mid position, maximum, and end of outstroke with parabolic arc with thick lines. During dwell period become constant, comes along one more reference line. So this is the reference line to construct this acceleration diagram. Next, from the beginning of return stroke, exactly at 1 by 4th of outstroke become maximum using this formula value. Exactly at 3 by 4th of return stroke distance become maximum, then the end of return stroke. Join these points with parabolic arc at exactly at mid position of return stroke become zero. That point comes along reference line. Join this beginning, maximum, mid position, maximum, and end of return stroke with parabolic arc during second dwell period. So this value become constant. That path lies along the reference line, show with thick horizontal line up to the end of cam rotation. Dear students, this is the method to construct displacement diagram, velocity diagram, and acceleration diagram under cycloidal motion. I hope you all understand how to construct these diagrams under cycloidal motion. Next, we will see how to construct the cam profile under the condition when the axis of the follower passes through the axis of the camshaft. Step 1. According to the given data, we know that the minimum radius of the cam, that is equals to 50 millimeter, and also make sure what type of follower it contains. The given problem contains knife-edged follower. With reference to this, with proper tools, draw a circle of radius 50 millimeter called base circle. Find the CG of the base circle, call it as O. Through this point O, draw a line vertically with thin straight axis line up to some certain position. Where it exactly this axis line intersect the base circle, mark that point, call it as zero. Next, with reference to this axis line and point zero, draw the shape of the knife edged follower. So this is the shape of the knife edged follower. To construct this knife edged follower, use proper tools. Scale is not required. Construct up to a certain height. Then make sure This is the axis of the follower passing through the axis of the camshaft. Make sure this condition. In the next step, in order to mark outstroke, first dwell, return stroke, and the second dwell angles with reference to O0 path. With reference to O0 path. Before to mark these angles, we should make sure the direction of rotation of the cam. Here, the direction of rotation of the cam, that is in counterclockwise direction. This is in counterclockwise direction. If it is in counterclockwise direction, we need to mark first outstroke, first dwell, return stroke, second dwell period in clockwise sense with reference to O0 path. With proper tools, first, as a center of O, with reference to O0 in clockwise sense, mark 160 degree, take this path up to the circumference of base circle. From the end of outstroke, again mark another 30 degree, represents dwell period. Again, from the end of first dwell, mark another 100 degree, represents return stroke, take this path up to the base circle circumference. Remaining 70 degree represents the second dwell period of the cam. Now, like this, we can mark the outstroke, first dwell, return stroke, and second dwell angles of the cam. Next, according to the procedure to construct cam profile, we need to divide this outstroke angle and return stroke angle into selected even number. We need to divide this 160 into 6 equal parts, because that is the selected even number. If we divide this 160 degree into 6 equal part, like 160 divided by 6 equal to that number with reference to this O0 in clockwise, divide this 160 into 6 equal part, take all those division points, this paths up to the circumference of base circle, then name this division points along the circumference of base circle, like from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, divide this return stroke angle into 6 equal parts, like 100 divided by 6. Nothing but for every 16.66 degree from here in reverse direction, 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and 0 dash. Like this, divide this 100 degree into 6 equal parts, name the divisions along the circumference of the base circle. Next step. Here we can see, extend all these respective paths during outstroke and return stroke up to some certain position, up to some certain position. Extend their paths up to some certain position out of this, outside of this base circle, outside of this base circle. Next, we need to mark the intersecting points. We need to mark the intersecting points during outstroke and return stroke along their respective paths with reference to the respective divided points during outstroke and return stroke. In order to find this intersecting points with reference to this divided points, again, we need to go back to the displacement diagram constructed under cycloidal motion. Here we can see, this is the displacement diagram constructed under cycloidal motion. Here, first intersecting point coincides at 0. The second intersecting point B lies along the first vertical. Measure the distance between 1 to B. Similarly, the distance from 2 to C, 3 to D, 4 to E, 5 to F, and 6 to G during outstroke, during return stroke, 6 dash to H, 5 dash to J, 4 dash to K, 3 dash to L, 2 dash to M, 1 dash to N, but P coincide at 0 dash. We need to measure this vertical distance correspond to this respective divided points. We can mark all these intersecting points with during outstroke and return stroke. Now here, along this path with reference to 1, mark B, because point A, first intersecting point, coincide at 0. This is B along this path with reference to 1. Then mark C with reference to 2, the distance between 2 to C from the displacement diagram during outstroke. Then D with respect to 3, E with reference to 4, F with reference to 5, G with reference to 6, H with reference to 6 dash, J with reference to 5 dash, K with reference to 4 dash, L with reference to 3 dash, M with reference to 2 dash, N with reference to 1 dash. P coincide at 0 dash. That point lies along the circumference of the base circle. So like this, we need to mark the intersecting points with reference to divided points along their respective path during outstroke and return stroke. In the final step, we need to join all these intersecting points during outstroke and return stroke with thick parabolic arc from point A. With thick parabolic arc A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to F, F to G, G to H, H to J, J to K, K to L, L to M, M to N, N to P. Then during second dwell period, this path camp profile comes along the base circle only, P to A. So this is the method to construct the camp profile according to the given data. Here, finally, make sure the axis of the follower passing through the axis of the camshaft. Now, when this cam rotates in counterclockwise direction, the first 160 degree rotation of the cam raises the follower from BDC to TDC. Next, first dwell period, it keeps the follower at TDC. Next 100 degree rotation of the cam, it lowers this 100 degree rotation of the cam further. It lowers the follower from TDC to BDC. During second dwell period, 70 degree rotation of the cam, it stables the follower at BDC. Like this, the relative motion takes place between cam and follower.